Bonjour, ladies and gentlemen. Hatterbox here with some more Xenogears. When we last left off, we were trying to find an intruder who somehow got in here. I cannot remember which direction I'm going. I'm assuming I have to go down. Yeah, I came from that way on the elevator. We're just going to make our way down. I'm not entirely sure where I'm supposed to go. But that is the part of the adventure that everyone likes, as well as random encounters, which I find that in this area are kind of very annoying, like exceedingly annoying, so I skip these because these encounters are ridiculously hard, like even for this area. I might have to sit down and grind for a little bit and cry to myself to sleep, but yeah, it's not fun. Alright, see what we can do here. Stuck on that, alright. This is gonna be a butt, isn't it? Oh man, oh, not encounters. It's this particular encounter right here that's really annoying, just because, like, you know, they only take one damage, they have 6 HP. And I'm just sitting here hitting them one at a time, and it's kind of annoying. Just because this is the only form of damage they take, they only take one damage. So it's kind of pointless to use any flashy moves because it does nothing. No matter how powerful your attack is, it does just one damage. And these triangle attacks are super, super slow. And it's just degrading me. I mean, don't get me wrong, they're really easy to kill, but man. Alright, moving along. Hopefully no battles will start to try and kill me. Well, there's a ladder there. Let's hope I can take this unopposed. Seems like I just did. Oh, come on. This one's not gonna be nice to me, is it? Oh man, this is a horrible, horrible angle. Whoop. Oh man, I just made it. Oh man. Oh man. Oh, I don't know if I can jump that. Okay. Oh, the torture. No! Gosh, that... Oh man. This is going to be a long journey, along with encounters too. This is going to be fun. I hate these guys more than anything. Those guys, more than any other enemy right now, are just annoying the heck out of me because they do a crap ton of damage, and then when you kill one of them, they get super strong. So if you don't kill it in one turn, it just wrecks you. So it's like impossibly hard. It one-shots you at that point. So... yeah, I'm just gonna try to get across here. Alright, we seem to be okay for the moment. Hopefully I can, okay. Just don't move. And we can make it to the other side unhindered. Unless I get a random encounter at the very end. I would, scream and die. There we go. Let's get on this platform and head downwards. Yes, I do. I didn't really get to explore the rest of the base like I wanted to. But, you know, that too lazy to go back. These monsters are insanely hard, so... yeah, let's keep on going. Let's get an encounter at the door, by the way. They like to greet us with an encounter. Here, I'll just show you a little bit of these enemies. So 44 damage, you know, it doesn't seem like a lot. Actually, you know, I'm not even going to show you guys. The reason being is when I kill one of them, you know, the other one gets powerful, but he can attack up to 3 times in one turn and can kill every single party member. He can actually, with a single attack, attack multiple people multiple times in one turn and kill us all in one shot. I literally just had that happen to me. It is not fun. So I'm just going to heal up here. All right, let's head down. I don't know why they have those insanely difficult enemies. I know Xeno Sug, where the series of Xeno has a ton of enemies, but man, they like to go a little overkill sometimes. Well, we're practically in Laputa right now. Yeah, we're going down deeper into the catacombs. I can't remember what they're called. They're like the it's like the library or something. Or, Musa. I think he has Musa. Wants to become the god, but he cannot because he's, not the the nicest of men. Getting flashbacks of Joe. PTSD is setting in as I fight these enemies. I remember how incredibly difficult they are, and I want to go and jump off a cliff. I'm sorry. Alright, my pants are peed. I have fled in terror. Yeah, this place is... Oh, well, I think I know where I'm going. That was probably a, it's probably gonna be the boss, so... I mean, thank God for that save point. Oh shoot, what was her voice? Once we get through that manhole, we'll be able to enter that hangar. Okay. Yeah, that's right, this was a whole detour to get down into the hangar where we originally wanted to get to. With, Faye. And I am thoroughly disappointed that this was the whole point of what we were doing. It was a big detour. Oh yeah, it's the creepy room. I understand why they set it up this way now. Who's our intruder here?
There's the intruder.
I think that's the voice. Oomph, you again. You pest on making my job any easier. I don't know your voice. Oh, it's you?
Oh, it's you!
I can't remember her voice, to be honest. Dominia.
Never thought I'd come across Zebzine in a place of escape.
I think that's her voice.
I'll take Zebzine. Originally, this belonged to us, Solaris.
I can't let you have that gear.
Ha! Then try and stop me.
Huh?
That child. Hey. You. Are you the daughter of Nikolai?
Shoot, this is hard.
Undoubtedly, I am the daughter of Nikolai, Maria Balthasar. What about it? I see. So you're his beloved daughter to whom he offered himself to undertake that difficult task.
That's a big mouthful.
Hey, young girl, you want to hear an interesting story? Let's see. How about the cursed secret of Zebzine? What do you mean? What do I mean? You'll understand it when you hear the story.
Is this a battle story?
For the past several decades, our scientists had put so much effort into the research to create evolved gears. Regardless of how great a pilot one is, as long as it is human, there will always exist a time lag and a human error when interfacing with a machine. That's when your father, Nikolai, was targeted. He was a genius in the field of cranial nerve mechanisms. They made Nikolai search for a way for humans to go beyond humans, by merging humans and machines. In other words, they were trying to create a new life, and an ultimate living weapon, by connecting a living human brain to a gear directly. It would have stayed as a mere fantasy without Nikolai, but that genius made that fantasy come true. That's a lie. My father wouldn't do such a horrible thing. I don't lie, Maria. This is the truth. Your splendid father succeeded in fusing man and machine. And he opened the gates to hell for the lambs. As a matter of fact, various data and components obtained from the war in Ignis and the battling in Kislev were used as experimental materials. That is how special humanoid mutants, Wells, were born. Wells created in Solaris were tested on the surface. Only the Wells that passed the test were dismantled, restructured, and reborn. They became the gear's central control circuit and became the part of the machine. It's all the result of your father's great research. Zebzine is the prototype of a man-made machine fusion gear. In other words, Zebzine was completed at the cost of innumerable land-dwellers' lives. And in the nerve circuit of Zebzine lies whoever this is. Don't you think you've said enough, Domina? Dominia? Who is it?
Oh, it's you, Billy. Or Jesse. Why are women so gossipy? They jabber about things they shouldn't be talking about. Hopeless.
Dad! Josiah! You!
Oh, I'm doing terribly right now on my voices. I'm so sorry. What are you doing in Shafar? At one point, weren't you considered to be the next Gibbler and Commander-in-Chief?
Don't get so excited. I think you've played with enough fire for today. Just go home. Maria is the only one who can operate Zebzine. You should be well aware of that.
Fools! Don't get so cocky. The party's just begun. But I guess it's all right. My mission is complete. All that's left is... Maria, I'm afraid I must go now. Enjoy your party.
Wait! Dominia!
Got my voice acting on point. Faza.
She's gonna become French, isn't she? Hey, Maria, don't mind what she told you.
Huh? This is...
Looks like our guests have arrived. Let's go upstairs. The Yggdrasil is also accommodated in the dock. I'm sure the other guys are making a fuss over it. I have an ominous premonition. I doubt it, but they could have,
What?
You know, I swore I took Zebzine with me to battle.
Zebzine.
She's gonna become French. It's just a natural tendency of mine. The Solaris gear units are on... The Solaris gear units are on a high speed. Interception course with Shavar. It would be reasonable to believe that their main targets are going to be the four gate generators. They're probably planning on finishing us off since Dominia's demolition has weakened the gate output. We have scrambled our interceptor units, but I do not know how they will fare. The people of Shavar are not accustomed to gear tactics. I want to avoid unnecessary sacrifices, if at all possible. Yeah, I know, Doc. We'll go. We're already involved, and we can't just stand by and watch these people die.
What was her voice again? I can't remember. Faye. I don't like the idea of working for free, but I don't like the idea of turning tail and running from them even more. Let's do it. It doesn't matter who they are. I'll take them all down in my brigadier. Yes, we'll do what we can to protect the people here.
Oh, gosh.
Since the day I met you all, there's been nothing but trouble. But I've come this far with you all. I guess there's no point in bleeping about it.
Yes, that was, I was about to actually curse there, I'm sorry.
I'll show them what happens when they tick the Great Rico off. I will go too. The enemy was able to get in here because they... I will go too. The enemy was able to get in because they let the Yggdrasil in. We can't allow the people of this country to be in danger because of us.
Yeah, right on. Go for it, youngins. We're dependent on you. Especially since my life also depends on it. I have no intentions of kicking the bucket here.
Shut up! Dad, could you say... not say anything?
Alright, I know. Why can't you be more nicer?
Alright, Atina's gonna help you out too.
Huh? Gonna help you out? Help? Whatever. Gonna chew help? Atina, what are you doing here?
Well, in all the bustle, she somehow tagged along.
What am I gonna do? This isn't a game. It's dangerous, so go back to the Yggdrasil. Okay, Hatina? Be a good girl.
Hatina's not a good girl. I'm in that dangerous age right now. And Hatina can help you. I'm going along with all of you. You understand? I didn't even read that last part.
Alright. Don't come crying to me when things get out of hand.
So they call you Hatina also? Many of your friends live in the city. Do you want to go meet them later?
Really? They're all here? Yay! I finally found them! Hatina's friends, they're here! Now, let's put everything into it. Everything... everyone, we have to give it our best shot.
Here's the breakdown of the enemy gear units. As I have explained before, four separate units are each headed for their respective generators. From the information collected in Shavar, we have a good idea of the capabilities and composition of the gear units. However, there is one giant gear that they are holding back that we have no information about.
An unidentified giant gear. It can't be.
Allow me to put it on screen.
Oh. Oh, that's the one that he was commanding, wasn't it?
This is... Axine? What's with that creepy gear? Do you know anything, Maria? Axine is the second gear my father designed. Zebzine's sister gear. But Axine wasn't completed. Other than Zebzine, father did not make any more. He was supposed to have burned the plans. So, why?
People of Shavar, hear me.
That voice? No. Father?
I'd heard some interesting rats had run into there. Just in time to test that Octoline. I can take you and Shavar all out at once. Hello, little rats. Come on out. Come on, my cute little guinea pigs.
Why is that? Why is father there? Calm down, Maria. It doesn't mean that Dr. Nikolai is inside. But, father's voice. Maria, get the hold of yourself. You intend to lose even before you fight. Against the very people who made you suffer. But...
Well, that is fine. Let us consider our next move. We must repulse the gear forces and protect the generator. To do that, let us split into four teams and intercept the enemy. The four of us will attack independently and defend each generator to the death. The other two wait here. It is dangerous, but we cannot turn back now. Even if one generator falls, it is a defeat for us.
Shoot.
Maria, you wait here.
Please, Maria.
Okay, I understand.
Next, the formation of the enemy gear forces. At Generator 1, there are two small gears and a complement of Solaris troops. If you do not hit them fast and hard, you will be banged down in a firefight. At Generator 2, there are three White Knights. They are very fast and maneuverable. At Generator 3, there is a large gear and a White Knight. Be careful, the large gear has some kind of special attack. At Generator 4, there is a large gear and a White Knight. The large gear seems to be a power gear. So, who will go to Generator 1?
Alright, let's think about this. It's gotta be Satan. Satan is the fastest moving character in the game. He told me that they were fast moving, so I have to strike fast. So Satan has to go to Generator 1. I want to hear information about Generator 2 again. So Generator 2 has three White Knights. They're pretty basic. Generator 3 has a special attack gear, so I can send Ellie, hopefully. Generator 4, I can send Rico. I honestly have to send Bart to Generator 2, because at the moment he's like very average, so he'd be able to averagely take them out. Or Billy's an option too. I'm gonna send Billy to Generator 2. So this is the special one. I'll send Ellie, and then for this one I'll send Rico.
Understood. The target assignments are Generator 1, Satan. Generator 2, Billy. Generator 3, Ellie. Generator 4, Rico. All these assignments okay?
Yes. Let's go. Hopefully this works.
Place her and get the preparations for the battle in order. Now, is this alright?
Let me get ready.
When you are ready, we will leave for the battle. Please hurry now. The enemy is almost there.
Got it. We've come this far. We're not gonna get beaten now. I'm so gonna die. I am so dead. But, you know, YOLO. You're gonna live once. I actually don't have any money, do I? I have a decent amount. You know what? I kind of just gotta go for it, so... Let's do this. Mainly because I don't have the money, and I don't, I wouldn't have the money to do anything, so let's do this. Well, alright then. Those defending the generators should now depart in their gears.
Everyone, please, be careful.
Oh, it's gonna be a tough one. Hopefully Rico can take that. Which mission will you do? The one I am mainly worried about right now is Rico, to be honest. Because Ellie's good. Billy is perfectly fine against those three white knights. Satan is the fast one, and that was the hint. But Rico, I don't know. I'm gonna have to do him right. Yes, I would like to eject my equipment. So my gear. Okay, let's look at him real fast. He's level 49, which is nice. This won't do anything for me. This is just the... Got my items ready, my abilities. Let me look at my gear abilities real fast. I can get out of my gear. That'd be weird. Okay. He doesn't have any abilities. He has fixed frame, but he literally has no abilities because I don't think I've used him once. I mean, he has that increased defense thing, and both of them are increased defense, but he doesn't get any extra options. Alright, well, let's get this done and over with in the next episode. Ha-ha! Sorry, I had to do that. Yeah, this is going to take a little bit longer than I would have expected it for this episode, so I'm going to continue in the next one. So, see you there.